Dickie's here with an interview with an Aussie icon. We love this guy, Dickie.
We certainly do, Carlos. Good morning, one and all. Aussie legends just don't get any bigger than Mick Dundee. Australia's Crocodile Dundee going global when it premiered in 1986. A couple of sequels, awards, and decades later, and Mick is back, sort of, as Paul Hogan stars as Paul Hogan and some pretty famous faces in the very excellent Mr. Dundee.
In the 80s, he was a national treasure.
That's a knife.
Rising to international stardom.
One word, hoax.
And then he was gone.
Paul Hogan, it's great to see you, sir. How are you doing?
I'm alive and reasonably well, mate. Thank you.
How's all this isolation, quarantine, whatever you call it, going with you?
Well, it doesn't worry me much. I'm a bit of a hermit by nature anyway. But it is a drag for everyone else.
It's a shame because you were supposed to be here for the premiere of this film of yours. What do we need to know about the very excellent Mr. Dundee?
Now Hollywood is calling.
We ask where the man from down under has been hiding.
No one's fallen from grace as hard as Paul Hogan.
And I was pretty upset because I thought Paul Hogan was already dead.
Oh. It's a good, funny script and sort of relatable, and everyone who got asked said, yeah, we'll be in it.
You got lots of cameos, people like Chris Hemsworth, Margot Robbie, Hugh Jackman. Did anybody say no?
No.
You killed any chance of the knighthood?
I don't care about the knighthood.
If I was my manager, I wouldn't get into any more trouble.
Do the opposite of that.
You have a knife, but mine's bigger.
That's not the law.
That's
not the law.
I've been doing this for 20 years. I think I'd know.
So you're up for a knighthood. You just got to kind of stay on the straight and narrow and make sure nothing goes wrong, right?
Yeah, and it doesn't quite work out that way.
Grandpa, are you getting a knighthood? Can I tell some kids my new school wet?
I don't have my driver's license.
Then just tell them you left it at home.
No, I don't have a driving license.
Tell me about John Cleese, because he takes the mickey out of himself too, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, it was great. You know, it was very flattering to have him in it, because, you know, John Cleese is wonderful. Basil Fawlty's one of the great obnoxious characters of all time.
Well, he is. I was shocked when they wanted to pull that episode, the Germans episode of Fawlty Towers. I mean, what do you make of all this stuff, this cancel culture?
I'm sorry, Basil Fawlty is offensive to everyone. He's an obnoxious character. He's supposed to be, and that's why we loved him. He's an awful man. I understand the sensitivity of people, and a lot of comedy some people would find offensive. I never wanted to have do comedy in a room with, you know, with 80 people laughing and 10 of them born crying because they felt hurt by it. I never did comedy with malice. Fake news, as the great president calls it, fake news, fake news.
How do you think he's doing, by the way?
Personally, I'd be sad to see him go because, to me, he's the most entertaining politician in the world. He's right up there with Caligula, Mussolini. I remember the great Idi Amin, the most amazing man there's ever been. He's in that category. As long as they don't really touch anything, he'd sooner stay around. Personally, from a greedy point of view.
Well, you know, there's talk about Australia becoming a republic one day. President Hogue's, you know, it's got a ring to it.
Got a nice ring to it, yeah. Sir Hogue's, President
Hogue's. Speaking of the royals, you haven't seen Harry and Meghan around. You haven't had them around for a barbie or anything, have you?
No, I'm investigating that at the moment because Harry knows I'm here. He visited my old house. So I have nice connections with the royals. I went to see Crocodile Dundee 2 sitting in the theatre between Charles and Diana in London.
Wow.
And that's with them nudging me when they like funny events. Doesn't get any more surreal than this, does it?
Come on. Come and say g'day. I'll slip an extra shrimp on the barbie for you.
Hogs, one of the centrepieces of your career was, of course, the famous Shrimp on the Barbie tourism campaign. It's kind of different these days. We're telling Americans not to come to Australia. It's sad, isn't it?
They're not welcome anywhere at the moment. I'm working hard on a vaccine, and if I come up with a vaccine, that'll free us all up.
Crisis over, folks. Hogs is working on the vaccine. We have more of that interview this morning on Today Extra and the whole shebang on Weekend Today. Spoke, had a very lengthy conversation with them. The very excellent Mr. Dundee premieres exclusively on Amazon Prime Video on Friday. It's worth a look.
You forgot a very important cameo.
What's the name?
Who else was in it, Dickie?
Well, it's Margot Robbie and Chris Hemsworth.
Yeah, you mentioned that. You've already mentioned them. Who else?
Who else?
Well, I have a small but pivotal role.
Do you? How pivotal?
Well, it's small.
What do you mean by pivotal?
I mean it's a great turning point in the film, Carlos.
I love it, Dickie. We can't wait to see it. We can't wait to see you, our shining acting god.
Yeah.
Thank you.